lighting.
I'm excited to see the lighting.
I am so excited to see David's lighting.
I cannot wait to see the lighting for this. I think it's going to be fabulous.
Like the skyorama thing, the projections, like I cannot wait to see it all come together. I'm thrilled.
I'm really excited because, I mean, a show about electricity, I immediately thought, like, the lighting has to be amazing, right? Like lasers and the hydro stuff, I don't know words about lighting. But, you know, hologram, that's what I was trying to think of. Stuff like that. And from what I've heard, like, they're playing with projections and using light in ways that they don't typically use it and having it kind of playing with it throughout the whole show. And that's going to be awesome. And it sucks that that's, like, the last thing that gets added into the show is the light. So I have to wait pretty much, like, right before the audience does to know what that's going to be. Yeah, definitely excited for that.
I found a lot of inspirations, and I found a lot of inspirations in the research, which was really great. There was one photograph I remember from 1911 in Bloomington. It's an electric showroom where they show all the lighting fixtures hanging in the air and on tables that you could buy at the time. In 1911, 25 years before our play takes place, all of this electrified luxury was available to citizens of Bloomington, and it wasn't to the town. So my hope is to have lighting fixtures hanging throughout the space, and one side will be very Bloomington specific, and it will be drawn really from that particular piece of research. The play in and of itself really looks at these people in the farms. And you can think of it as, oh, well, they'll get electricity eventually. But when you set that in opposition to people in town who already had it and were living a much more advanced first world life, it shows a disparity that's really bothering, really troublesome, and why the REA came into existence. Grew up in America, you should come see the show because it's part of our collective history. You may have grown up in town, but it's still good to learn what other people were going through. So I think, and another reason to come see the show is if you ever had any ancestors who lived in the 1930s, which would be everyone, you should come see the show to learn about that particular part.